Hi, John here, and this is a combined bi-monthly update on my solar PV performance for April and May. April's bill from Octopus Energy arrived really late. By the time it arrived in the sort of middle of May, towards the end of May actually, I thought, well, it's pointless putting April out now, so I'll just roll the two together. So let's kick off. This is the ESO's monthly insights, and you can see here in April, 46% of electricity came from zero carbon sources, peaking at actually 80% on the 10th of April at 2 p.m. in the afternoon. Still using gas as the largest source of fuel. Wind was second largest power source. And you can see that's broken down here in this chart. And this is May. 44% in May. Electricity came from zero carbon sources, peaking again, 80%. And again, wind was the second largest power, contributing 19% in total is the breakdown. So a bit closer to home. Oh, we had a sparrowhawk in the garden, landed on the garden fence. We had some great weather in April, and even better weather in May. I did take the time in April to clean the solar panels with the water-fed pole. I've got a good setup now, and it works extremely well. So I will do a separate video on that. I know I've done a video on how to clean the solar panels and remove lichen. I'll put a link to that up in the top of the screen. But now I've got into a sort of a maintenance clean, which I can do in half an hour, including setting up. Gas boiler been turned off. It was turned off on right at the end of April, actually. So it's been off for the whole of May. Ripple Energy and our wind turbine in Wales in April, it earned us £70.52. In May, it earned us £63.48. Here's the totals to date from the start in March 2022. Total savings to date so far, £503.71. Kirk Hill, which I've also invested in, is coming along nicely. Should be going live early in 2024. So I have total ownership now, which covers 109, almost 110% of our total electricity needs. You can actually go up to 120% in total. Solar start, solar end, I haven't included April here. The solar start in the blue at the bottom, getting earlier and earlier, 6 o'clock, and then into the quarter to sixes even. And then conversely, at the end of the day, which is the red bars, that's getting later and later in the day, depending on the cloud conditions. Generation is this chart here. So this is peak again for May. 6 kilowatts is quite normal. 6.1, 6.2, some 6.3s. Time of day of that peak is shown in the blue line across the middle even. So this is our PV totals and daily average over the month. For April, it was 751 with a daily average of 25 kilowatt hours. And in May, we were 819, which is 26. In a minute, we'll have a look at the previous years and see how that's trundling along. This is both arrays together, so you can see the split between the two arrays. So I'm not seeing that much drop on the new array with the slightly smaller Solis inverter. This is the contribution of the Powerwall, Tesla Powerwall and solar to our overall self-power. So in April, we were 88% self-powered for the month, and in May, we are 87% self-powered for the month. These are the years on years for the months of April and May for the arrays. You see a steady decline in April from April 2020. Conversely, in May, we had a bumper one in 2020, which we've never really peaked and got anywhere near. It's interesting to see the history over the course of the years. These are from the Tesla Powerwall app, and it's saying that the estimated savings based on our tariff plugged into the Tesla Powerwall app is £255 saved in April and £273 in May. How accurate that is, I don't really know, to be honest. The other bit I look at the bottom here is the solar offset, so 82% of our energy was offset by solar generation in both months, actually, which is interesting. So both had more solar, but we also had more home usage, like for like. So we still came through at 82%. This is our average daily house usage and average daily grid usage. So for April, it shows us at 32 kilowatt hours on average a day. And from the grid, it was 8 kilowatt hours. And in May, well, the month isn't shown there, it is actually that last column, 33 and 7. So we use more, but we use less on the grid. It's the quick summation of that chart. So sent to the grid was 27 kilowatt hours during the month of May and 14 in April. Fairly good, certainly better than previous Aprils and Mays. We'll take that as a positive. From the grid, April 2023 was 230 and 222 in May. So again, up and down really. So slightly less in May, which is good. And we're getting to that time of year now where we're dropping off and having less and less from the grid. That will undoubtedly change as we change our heating setup at home, where we have the air source heat pump. It'll be interesting to see what happens with our figures going forwards. This is a new chart. I was looking at the number of days per month when we were pulling less than 100 watt hours of grid pull from a day. So over the course of the month, how many days were we pulling less than or equal to 100 watt hours from the grid. In April we had 16 days where we achieved that, and in May it was 14. And looking back through the figures, we didn't achieve that again until September 2021, which was quite interesting. And that's probably when we're away on holiday. I don't know how long that chart will last, but we'll see. It's of interest to anybody. Let me know in the comments down below. Eddi, this is the solar diverter from excess solar heating our hot water. In April, 49 kilowatt hours diverted, and interestingly, in May, it was also 49 kilowatt hours. So we've got our running totals there, total of £105 saved based on our off-peak cost of 8.5 pence per kilowatt hour on the current tariff. This is the cars. I'm not really going to talk too much through this because it's fairly self-explanatory and a bit historic now. You can see that we're still doing fairly well on green home charging, 45% in April and 42% in May, which is pretty good seeing as we're putting in sort of 260 or almost 300 kilowatt hours during the course of a month. Tesla is using most of the mileage and the Zoe just running around locally. We're now paying for our supercharging with Tesla. That started in April. We did 8 charging sessions in April. Not all of those were costed because I think it was 23rd of April from memory that our free supercharging miles run out, hence the lower cost of £8.82. And then May, all those 4 charges were at a cost of £66.96. The Zoe, I found a very wet patch in the passenger side footwell. Having a chat with Matt at Go Green Autos, where I got the car from, he said it's probably the scuttle, which is full of debris and then overflowing and then draining into the passenger compartment, and he was 100% right. This is the scuttle here, this black plastic cover over the top of it with all the little square holes in. So I needed to take that off across the whole top. It's quite easy to do actually, it took me half an hour or so, and then clean down in between under the scuttle, and it was full of debris, dead leaves and twigs and gunk, little swimming pool in there. So once I cleaned it all out, all the water drained out and it was fine. I did the other side as well, driver's side, while I was at it, which wasn't as bad, but it was only the passenger side that was overflowing. Dried the car out, since then it's been fine. Here's our gas spreadsheet. So we've got 2 months to look at here and go through. So the 5th of April to the 4th of May, total of 62.9 meters squared or 705.7 kilowatt hours. Total bill there of £43.08. In May, no gas at all. So all we're paying for is a standing charge, £8.04 over 31 days, plus VAT. So £8.44. As soon as I get the gas disconnected and the meter removed, then we won't be paying the standing charge. So it's about £100 a year that we will save. This is electricity, 2 months worth there. The bill for 5th of April through to the 4th of May is £37.10. And then the last bill we've had for May is £43. And these are the bills in a lot more detail. If you want to pause on those and have a look, by all means do. Firstly for electric and then for gas. You've got the tariff on the right hand side and then the unit breakdown on the left hand side. And this is the Octopus Energy app for initially month of May and then for 2023 for the total for both electricity and gas for what we've used. And then this is a summary, a recap of our electric bill and gas bill for April and May. And there you go. That's it. That's the update. Apologies it's a bit late, but better late than never, as they say. I suspect my next update will be on the heat pump installation because that is happening or starting on the 30th of June. So happy days. Take care. Speak to you soon. Thanks for watching.